press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss an update from Shimmaru.
Arjun Singh.
Please have a seat, gentlemen. I thought that I would see you tomorrow morning. Then my PA told me about your tight schedule. Thank you, Ajay.
Thank you, sir.
I shall come straight to the point, Mr. Damani. 2 days ago, we received your draft for 20 million and this contract as well. We have studied it and we can work on it.
Well, then I guess it's a deal.
Sir, there's a small problem. You have given us a 5% service charge and we were expecting 7%.
Before we discuss that, I would like to see the security arrangements and facilities of your firm.
Sure. But for that, we'll have to go to the third floor and we can discuss on the way.
Yeah, sure.
Please, follow me.
Mr. Shantanu, we have 32 diamond mines in South Africa.
Come.
We send almost 50% of rough diamonds from our mine to Jaipur for cutting and polishing. But they are not very professional. That's the reason why we want to try out your firm this time.
Excuse me, we are here.
Sir,
come.
This week we'll be sending you 500 carat diamonds from South Africa. If we get quality as well as on-time delivery, we'll increase our quota.
That's great.
So before making any decision, please look at the bigger picture, Mr. Shantanu.
Sure.
Sir, sir.
This is our state-of-the-art cutting and polishing section. The worker's shift ends at 7 o'clock and that's why the room is empty at this moment. Excuse me, Mr.
Yes,
Singh.
Please.
In this unit, the polished diamonds are matched, sorted and checked out.
Excuse me for a minute.
Sure.
Hello, Mr. Jethmalani. Yes, I've reached Mumbai. No, sorry, I won't be able to come to your office. It's already 7. Yes, I suggest I'll send my secretary, Mr. Arjun Singh, to your office. He'll collect the papers. Yes, of course. I'll see you at the minister's party. Okay. Arjun Singh?
Yes.
Go to Mr. Jethmalani's office and collect the papers.
Okay.
And come to the hotel.
You won't have any problem going out. The doors will open by themselves.
Fine.
There's a fixed paneling of 12 inches, stainless steel on every wall of this floor. This is the most secure place in this building. It's impossible to get in here. The diamonds are sorted in this windowed section. And as you know, natural light is very necessary for that.
Hi. Punch in your code.
Okay.
Outside these windows are made of 3 inches thick stainless steel.
Brother Mike, where are you? Hello. Just to let you know, I'm in. It's time to win.
At 8 o'clock in the night when we shut down, 440 volts of current run through them. Coming in contact with them will be 100% fatal. This grill cannot be blasted open either.
I'm impressed. This is a pretty good setup. Shall we leave?
Please, come. And by the way, the entire building is monitored 24 hours by closed circuit cameras. This place is like a fortress.
I'm happy we are in safe hands. It'll be a pleasure doing business with you.
Thank you, Mr. Damani. I assure you, there has never been a theft here, and there will never be one. You won't ever have any complaints from us.
So we're ready to play.
Yeah, we are in position.
It's showtime. We're on. What should we do? Should we abort?
No way. Mike, plan B.
It's plan B. Office of the Diamond Corporation of India, where the biggest theft of the millennium has been committed. We have learned from reliable sources that
this
theft
is the biggest heist ever reported. Yes, this is the biggest heist ever
reported. Let's watch what happens next. The CBI is reaching in a short while.
Oh my God, is it true? Oh, the police is here.
Excuse me, sir, one question, please.
No comments. Sir, just one question. The heist. In spite of such pulp arrangements, though DCOI kept the spoils out of reach, he managed to get it.
Why are you all glorifying him? He's a thief, not God.
Sir, don't you wonder how he could commit the robbery in spite of such tight security?
Security is only for the white-collared.
So, sir, what's for the thieves?
Prison.
One more question, sir.
Only prison.
Sir, please.
Sir.
This thief was very smart.
Okay.
All the recorded evidence we had in our video cameras, he erased everything. Completely wiped out clean.
Okay.
Did you get something?
Good morning, sir.
You are a very positive man. Whenever I see you at any crime scene, you wish me good morning, sir. If anyone dies, then good morning, sir. And even if there's a bomb blast, then good morning, sir.
Sir, you're my senior. And it's my duty to wish you good morning, sir.
Your duty is to catch the criminal. Any clues?
No, sir. We only got the staff's fingerprints and no one else's.
Mark this.
Yes, sir.
Sir, he's a very cunning thief. Not just one or two, he has stolen diamonds by the kilos. And that too through this little hole. Sir, I fail to understand how this is possible.
Wherever he goes, anything is possible.
Who's he, sir?
Prince.
Sir! Sir! Sir, what are you doing?
Who are you?
I'm your servant, sir. PK!
Sir, that means you really don't remember anything?
Who? What is my name?
Your name? That is your name, sir.
What's that?
Prince. Your name is Prince, sir. Prince.
Prince. This house?
It's your house, sir. Sir, you have another house in the city. You often come here for weekends. 3 days ago, you called me from your house in the city and called me there. I had just reached the building compound when that arrived.
What's that?
Your car, sir. Your arm was bleeding, sir. I asked you how you got hurt, but you scolded me, sir. On the way, I asked you again whether we should go see a doctor, but you scolded me again. Sir, you kept yelling at me all the way till we came here.
And I hadn't lost my memory then?
Yes, sir. You remembered everything. You said to me that go and bring first aid box from the bedroom drawer. I got it, sir. I bandaged you too, but you fell unconscious. And when you regained consciousness, you started strangling me. And before I could free myself and say something to you, sir, but you fainted while clutching your head, I couldn't tell you anything about your condition or the condition of your car.
The condition of my car?
It's in very bad shape, sir. Look over here, the bullet holes. One is here and the other one is here. Two of them. Sir, I think someone must have definitely followed you and tried to kill you. Sir, between you and me, there are only two types of people who shoot bullets. The first are goons and the second one are them. The police. So, no doctor, no police. Right, sir? Sir, you have another house in the city. Your name, that is your name, sir.
What's that?
Prince. Sir, I think someone must have definitely followed you and tried to kill you. Sir, can I get anything else for you? Okay, sir.
PK, what do I do?
You shift things around, sir. I mean, sir, you work at an import-export firm. Sir, I have your visiting card as well. Here it is. We have reached the office, sir.
I'm reporting live from the headquarters of Wolf International. As you can see behind me...
But what's with the men in blue shirts and black jackets? These are policemen. Why is the police outside your office? Sir, do you know about the police?
PK, you said that I have an apartment in the city.
Yes, sir, you have it. It's close by.
Which way?
Left from the highway. Let's go, sir. Keep going, sir. Our building is ahead.
The police?
Police? No, sir. Everyone dressed in blue isn't the police. They are in orange jackets, the municipality. They must have come to clear the garbage.
They are not the police?
Yes.
They are more dangerous than the police.
Sir, can I go home, sir?
Go.
Thank you, sir.
Wait. If I don't come back home within 24 hours, inform the police.
Okay, sir.
Who are you? Prince.
These are your MRI scans. They are all clear. Your nervous system is in perfect order. There are no marks of internal injury in your skull. All your blood reports are absolutely clear. You remember everything that happened in the past 2 days. The names of people, addresses, how to drive a car, how to come here. And I think you can do all the basic things that are part of our daily chores.
Then why did I suddenly suffer this memory loss?
The human brain is still a big mystery to medical science. Your case is very strange, Mr. Prince. But trust me, I'll try my level best. But it'll take some time. You will have to be patient.
That you are very fast. And today I've seen it for myself. I'm impressed.
So am I.
I don't ever like wasting bullets, so better don't make any smart moves.
Who are you? And what do you want?
You'll know what we want very soon, I'm sure. Now come on.
Indian Government Research and Intelligence Portfolio. I don't think you have ever heard about our unit. You're talking to Colonel Khanna, Bureau Chief. Let me come straight to the point, Prince. Where is that coin?
Coin? Which coin?
The same antique gold coin for which you struck a deal with Sarang for 500 million rupees. Yes, we know. There are many ways of extracting information, so it's better that you tell us quickly. Where is that coin?
I don't know about any gold coin.
So you want to act tough?
Now get up, come on.
Start the brain mapper. Let's load his memory. Take note of it.
his memory.
Sir, how can it be possible?
Try once more. Okay, try once again. But you know, Colonel, all the earlier information is missing. And it seems like he has...
Like he has used the coin on himself.
On himself? But why?
There are many people who are after this coin. We came all the way from India for this coin. It is very difficult to hide this coin. But it is very easy to use it and forget everything.
Sir, we should keep a strict watch on him. Maybe he might remember something. Gradually, when his life and memory come back to normal...
Normal? Roy, he's Prince. His life was never normal and never will be. Take him. You've lost your memory and the reason is that coin. So let me tell you a few important things. Sarang wanted to give you 500 million for that coin. You need to remember just one thing. You had that coin in your hands. And you'll have it again. Because you aren't doing this job alone. There's someone with you. Your partner.
Partner?
When your partner contacts you, tell him that the coin is worth much more than you could ever think. Sarang was offering you 500 million. We'll give you 1 billion. Do you understand? That coin is like God and only that can save your life. But you have got only 4 days. No one can save you after 4 days, not even God. Take him.
Candy Club, 9 p.m. Maya?
Sir, that's Mr. Sarang, your boss.
Have you ever felt that I'm not into import-export, but something illegal?
Never, sir, not at all. You're a very nice man. Actually, sir, once I was in need of money, and the amount which I had asked, you gave me double of that, sir.
Do you know any girl called Maya?
She's not just any girl, sir. She's your girlfriend. She works with you. In fact, you also said that you are going to marry her, sir.
Do you have Maya's number?
How can I have her number, sir? It must be saved in your mobile. But it was lost that night.
Maya.
Baby, shallow sahar, aankhon pe hai dil. so much. I thought I would lost you forever. Oh God, I was so scared. I was so scared. How's your arm now? Are you seeing me for the very first time? Prince, it's...
I'm sorry. Honestly, I don't recognize you. Maya?
You have lost your memory. But not my love. I'll remind you of our story. Those beautiful moments we spent together. But someone jinxed our precious love. Sarang, the biggest white collar criminal of Durban. But you were Sarang's real power. His number one man. Only a few were fated to play with Sarang. But no one could win against him. We wanted to start a new life. A life that belonged only to us. That weren't moments stolen from Sarang. You knew everything about Sarang. And only death could separate someone from Sarang if he knew so much about him. But you were never scared of death.
Maya, I'm going to steal Sarang's coin. Coin?
Yes, Sarang's coin. It was no ordinary coin. It was made in Sri Lanka 3,000 years ago. And it said that the gold it was created came from Ravana's chariot. And it's also said that it has magical powers. You made a plan that after stealing the coin, you would come home and pick me up. But that night, when I was waiting for you... Hello?
Maya.
Prince, where are you?
Maya, I have been shot.
What?
Relax. I'll be fine. Listen to me. I have stolen Sarang's coin. But his men are following me.
Prince, are you fine?
I'm fine, Maya. But you are not safe there. Get out of there immediately. Go somewhere safe. I'll contact you later. Okay?
But...
Maya, I love you.
I love you too. Prince, I couldn't do anything else but wait. Forget about Sarang, his coin and the money. You know, my friend Ruby knows a bar owner in Cape Town. I'll get a good job there. Please, Prince, please return the coin to Sarang so he can leave us alone. Right?
I don't have that coin.
But you said you have hidden that coin somewhere. Only the coin can save us from Sarang, Prince.
I have forgotten everything. And until I find that coin, you'll have to stay with Ruby. Many people are chasing after me for that coin. I'm not safe. I'll contact you myself after I find the coin, okay?
Okay. But you... Where will you look for the coin?
Sarang wanted to give you 500 million for that coin. There's someone with you. And only that can save your life. But you have only 4 days. No one can save you after 4 days, not even God.
Hello? Prince, this is Maya.
Maya?
Yes, Maya.
But I told you...
Look, meet me immediately at the boat club.
Are you fine?
Yes, I'm waiting for you at the pier number 4. Come as soon as possible.
Maya.
Okay?
Maya! Pier number 4.
Prince! Oh, Prince! Thank God you're okay. I was so worried.
How is your arm now? I've been trying to contact you for past 2 days. And you didn't even contact me either. Finally, I spoke to Sarang. And I have a 24 hours deadline. Anyway, we'll need that much time.
Who are you?
What's wrong with you, Prince? I'm Maya.
Prince. You are not Maya. But you know that I have lost my memory. And you're taking advantage of it. Why? Who are you?
What are you saying, Prince? What's wrong with your memory? I'm Maya. CBI officer Maya Malhotra. You're Maya. Your gun. Your ID. CBI officer, Prince.
CBI.
And this is your partner's. I mean mine. Officer Maya Malhotra. We are working with the CBI chief, Officer Khan. Now do you believe me?
These IDs could be fake.
Fake? Do you know what this is? The map of Sarang's house. And this is Sarang's case file, which has all his details. We came here to get Sarang arrested. Operation Durban Undercover. Stage 1, to win Sarang's trust and work with him. Stage 2, collect evidence against him and arrest him in the act. But it wasn't so easy to get to Sarang, because Sarang is South Africa's biggest white-collar criminal. So we posed as thieves ourselves and committed 3 high-profile robberies: Paris, Jakarta, and the Diamond Corporation of India. And after that, Sarang noticed us. He contacted us himself and gave us a proposal to join him. Then he gave us the job of stealing an antique coin from the Cape Town Museum. Our plan was that after we steal the coin and deliver it to Sarang, Officer Khan would arrest him in the act. The Durban police was after us because they didn't know we were undercover. After we separated that day, today is the day we met. We still have a lot to do, Prince, and I can't do it alone. I need you. And one more thing. We aren't just partners at CBI. We are life partners as well.
Here's the coffee. Without sugar and milk for sir, and for ma'am, sugar and milk on the side, right?
You remember everything other than names, isn't it?
What's in a name, Miss Maya? I'm very thankful that sir met you. Otherwise, I was fed up of answering his questions, ma'am. I became mad. Okay, sir.
That foolish servant of mine says that I work for Sarang's company, Wolf International. An unknown girl meets me and says that Sarang is a gangster and I am his right-hand man. And now there's you. You say that I'm an undercover agent for CBI and I was gathering evidence against
Prince.
Sarang.
Sarang isn't an ordinary gangster. He has offices all over the world. He operates from Durban, but he has connections with international cartels. I don't know about the lies that girl has told you. All I know is that your life is in danger. Because Sarang has contacts everywhere, from the ministry to the media. Sarang can go to any limits to wipe out his biggest of enemies, regardless of what price he has to pay for it. Sarang gets everything he wants. Now his eyes are only on that coin, and it's very important for us to find it, Prince.
And you don't know how dangerous Sarang is.
Nothing yet.
Contact Serena. Find out where Prince and his Maya are.
He has offered me 25,000 bucks. Send 50 before the club closes down.
Okay.
Hello and welcome to News One. I'm Pragya. Rahul Singh, son of Infrastructure Minister Vinod Singh, passed away in an airplane accident. We have learned from reliable sources that Rahul Singh was testing his new private jet. Rahul Singh's close friend and business associate has expressed his condolences.
Sorry, sir.
We have still not found out the reason behind this accident. But according to sources, there has been some...
For God's sake, Priya, you know I am with Sarang.
Just shut up, Mike. This is an emergency, okay? We are in trouble. Prince came back to Candy Club.
Oh my God. Why did he come there? Tomorrow he'll come here looking for me. Priya, I had told you before that...
Send rupees 50,000 today to Tony before the club closes, okay?
Forget about coin, Priya. It is very difficult to deceive Sarang or Prince.
Mike, you know what all I am doing. All this for us. You know I love you.
What are you thinking about?
About the coin.
I found my prince. So Prince will find his coin now. I don't want to leave. But I need to contact the department. They have suspicions on you. I also need to ask Sarang for more time.
Don't worry. I know very well. You'll surely find the coin. Okay?
Khan!
I didn't know you all will be already waiting here to welcome me. It's such a happy occasion.
The CBI was involved in the coin robbery. You didn't tell us that.
Sir, I didn't know that iGrip has interest in the coin as well.
It's clearly written in the 1st August circular that iGrip is the highest authority. Higher than CBI.
I'm sorry, sir, but I didn't read that circular.
What happened with the coin robbery case?
Maya has been able to locate Prince. And we are almost ready to nab Sarang.
We don't have anything to do with Sarang. Khan, we just want the coin. At any cost.
Fine, sir. The coin is yours. But Sarang is mine.
Okay.
You'll have to keep me informed about whatever you do. Just remember that.
Why just you? Then we should inform Sarang as well about the plan we have hatched to nab him. Actually, why don't we publish a newspaper? Times of Crime?
Khan, don't act smart.
Roy, I am smart. PK, try to remember. I need to know exactly. The other night, did we stop anywhere? Anywhere?
No, sir. I have told you so many times. That night, once we left from that house, we stopped only after we got here. That's all.
Car.
Oh,
Hi, baby.
Maya, guess what? I found the coin.
That's amazing, Prince.
Yes, I know it's amazing. Okay, tell me, what we need to do next?
Sarang is at his farmhouse at the moment, Santa Cabana. I'll contact him and arrange for the coin's delivery. Here, Sarang will come with his men. And there, Officer Khan will be ready with his men to nab him. There's a place amidst the mountains where Sarang can't hide or escape from. It's called Wild Extreme. Everything is set. Khan is reaching with his team. Where did you find the coin?
In the heel of my shoe.
Sarang.
My number one man. I heard that you were shot. I was worried. Where's the coin?
Where's our money?
Coin. There is something wrong, isn't it? How can everything end so easily, isn't it? Yes, now I remember. Where's your CBI team, Prince? They haven't arrived yet to arrest me. What was the name of that officer?
Khan. CBI officer Ali Khan. He hasn't arrived?
PK.
The police should have arrived on time, sir. After all, how long can criminals like us wait? Right, boss?
You have run enough, Prince. Who will save you now?
Boss, wait! Wait, please! This is a fake coin! It's a copy!
Give back the gun to me, Prince.
Thank you.
What are you thinking, darling? Wondering how your Maya can kill you? But Serena can kill you. Yes, Serena. Your Serena. Who could have done anything for you? Give me the real coin, Prince, or I'll kill you. I promise. Where is the real coin? Prince, you can do it. It's showtime.
Who are you?
Maya.
Another new Maya. Another new story. So, what's your story?
All I want to say to you is that, Prince, I love you very, very much. More than my own life. I won't tell you any story. I'll tell you the truth. You aren't Sarang's right-hand man, nor are you a CBI officer. You and I are professional thieves. We have been working with Sarang for many years.
The same old story. New twist. Interesting. Go on.
Few months ago, we had decided that we will leave this profession and settle down. But it was very difficult to do that. Sarang's organization is a one-way street. And there is no U-turn. We had only two options. Either we kill Sarang or get him arrested. We chose the second option. We contacted CBI Officer Khan. We offered him a deal that we can get Sarang arrested. But in return, we want all our past criminal records wiped out. Khan agreed. A few days later, Sarang gave us a job of stealing an antique gold coin. We got the opportunity we were waiting for.
Copy that. Send a request clearance at West and Aliwell.
The plan was that when we deliver the coin to Sarang after stealing it, then Officer Khan would arrest him in the act. The plan was foolproof as well as difficult. Successful, but we didn't know that the coin and the robbery will change our lives forever.
Go on.
I won't tell you anything else, Prince. CBI Officer Ali Khan will tell you the rest of the story.
You should have let me kill him, Sarang. Why did you stop me?
Serena,
don't make it personal, ever again. Until we find the real coin, he has to stay alive. Hail to die. You have loved him for 2 years, so hate him for a few days. You have just heard your prince sigh. He still has to bear a lot of pain. He must lose a lot of blood.
Can we discuss this in the private room? Okay, let's go to the common room.
Hello, Prince. I feel I'll have to introduce myself again. Khan, Ali Khan. Actually, we have been enemies or friends for a very long time. But this isn't the time to rake up the past. Seeing your condition, I'm assured that Sarang has used the coin on you.
Just one question. What the darn heck is this coin?
Let me tell you. Come. Lights. The story of this coin starts from here. Date. 24th August 2001. The place. Gwalior's Defense Research Laboratory. The characters. A team of chosen scientists from the country who were secretly carrying out research on nanotechnology. And the most proficient amongst them, Dr. Ram. After 8 years, Dr. Ram attained success in his mission. The mission belonged to the iGrip. iGrip has been spending millions on it.
What was Mr. Ram working on?
Dr. Ram was making a path-breaking memory chip. Through this chip, human memory can be extracted on a computer disk. It can be altered and re-implanted in the human brain again. Putting it in simple terms, it means that through this chip, any human being's thought process can be changed. The memory of an enemy can be altered and compel him to believe that he is our friend and not our enemy. A super intelligent person's memory can be implanted into thousands of other people and they all can be made super intelligent. A criminal's memory can be altered and he can be turned into a nice man. The possibilities were immense, medically and also for the country's defense.
How can that happen?
It has happened, Prince. With you. 2 weeks ago, when Dr. Ram was to make a presentation of this chip to iGrip, that very moment, his dead body was found instead. And the chip and its software were missing. According to the team's investigation, this was done by his assistant. He stole the chip and had fled to South Africa. iGrip's intelligence department found out that he struck a deal with a person who is known as Sherry. Sherry is a famous antique dealer who operates from Cape Town. And he's Sarang's biggest rival as well. He deals in defense secrets and smuggling of arms. Sherry knew what this chip was worth. So he sent word to his international buyers about this chip. And he made an intelligent plan to sell it. Frequently through auctions in Durban, Sherry would sell his priceless antiques. And that's why he...
He hid this chip in an antique coin.
Exactly. The plan was that the chip was to be sold at an antique auction in Durban. So that a deal is official. And the buyers can easily take the chip out of the country. Sherry arranged to send the coin from Cape Town to Durban, along with his other antiques, under the protection of the local police. Sherry's plan was good, but it didn't have one thing, which his biggest rival Sarang had. You both, the most cunning and professional thieves in the world.
When we stole the coin, we didn't know what was inside it. We had the coin. And Sarina was standing in front of us. Either Sarang grew suspicious of us, or he didn't want to take any chances with the coin. That was the reason why we couldn't contact Officer Khan. We didn't know that fate will play such a cruel game with us that would change our past, present, and our future.
You should only play the games you can win.
Whatever the game, you should know how to win. Let's shake hands. I have the coin. And you have the cash.
At the moment, everything is in my hands. The coin. Prince, my number one man. What deal has Officer Khan offered you to get me arrested?
I want to shoot you right now.
But when a weapon becomes rusty, we don't break the weapon. We just need to clean it. You have done a great job for me, Prince, by stealing this chip. Do you know what this chip is? I can make the entire world bow at my feet with this chip. I can rewrite life with it, starting with you. Mike. Today I'll clear the cobwebs in your mind. Erase all of Maya's memories from his mind. Don't leave anything behind, Mike. I want the prince who lives only for Sarang. Every step he takes will be for me. I want Prince, my number one man.
Don't do this, Sarang. You will regret it.
Relax, Maya. It's my turn to say it to you. It's showtime.
We are ready, sir.
Take a look, Maya. Prince has lost all the memories of you. Next time when he wakes up, you wouldn't be part of his memory or his world. Stop! Nobody moves. Give me the chip, Prince. You are making a big mistake.
You are making the mistake, Sarang. Maya was right. You will regret it.
Let's go.
separated, we had decided that we will meet at the beach house. But when I reached there, I saw that PK had already reached there. I understood that Sarang has still not found the coin. They were still looking for that coin. I kept observing you slyly so that you are not in danger from Sarang. I waited for the right moment to contact you.
That means I remembered everything, even after we separated. But Mike erased my memory with the help of that chip. Just like after deleting software from a computer, we need to restart the computer to clear all the traces. Similarly, you had an image of your memory in your brain at that time when you slept at night. And when you woke up in the morning, all the images were erased. It's not just about that coin any longer, but it concerns national security, Prince, and now you are also a part of it.
Do you think he has already met Khan?
I know he has met Khan.
Oh. Then he must have found out everything.
If he knew everything, he would have come running to me. Because if he doesn't come see me, then tomorrow will be Prince's last day.
Prince, there is something I didn't tell Officer Khan. That day, you sent me a voicemail.
Maya, I'm safe. I have hidden the coin. Gandhiji is looking after it. Maya, take care of the letters.
But what does it mean?
I think I sent this message from a fixed line. It must be a payphone. We should track it down.
I have already tracked it down. This phone booth is on Osborne Road.
Let's go. Maya, in the message I said, I have handed over the coin to Gandhiji.
And Nelson Mandela is considered the Mahatma Gandhi of South Africa.
Right. Maybe the coin is inside this. Okay, I suggest that you go out and keep a watch. I'll open this. The coin isn't in these.
This is our arms room. And this is where we have planned all our high-tech robberies. Thank God you didn't tell PK about this. Prince, that's no ordinary IC. They are high-powered tracking devices. And this is the receiver.
Come on, move. Jack, check in the kitchen. One guy go inside.
Yes.
Boss, you were right. Maya and Prince were coming here. We followed them as well, but...
But you lost them.
Right, boss.
If you don't find them by morning, then you will go missing as well.
Come on, guys. Let's go find them. Come on, move it!
There is a tiny thing hidden in this big city. And everyone's after it.
You will find it.
What does this coin look like? How does it look?
The same as the fake coin was.
The one which you gave to Sarang.
Right. But why did I hide that fake coin in my shoe?
Not you. I did. I kept that fake coin there.
You did?
Serena had woven her web of deceit around you. You had started believing her to be Maya. You would have never believed me. If I had contacted you at that moment, that's why I hid that fake coin in your shoe. But it was too late. It was too late, Prince.
I promise you, Maya, I'll find that coin for you.
Good morning, Prince. Don't be so surprised. I was waiting for you to wake up. How do you say this? Life is too short. You must know everything about the brain mapper now. Everything. But there is one defect that still remains.
And the effect of that defect is that your memory is totally erased each time you wake up from your sleep, my friend.
And the symptoms of this erase are nausea, temporary blindness, and headache.
And if your memory isn't reloaded in your brain, then your brain will keep crashing like this. It can lead to brain hemorrhage, sudden death. In this condition, you could live for 6 days. Today is the sixth day. In fact, you have only 8 hours left now. Find the coin and take your memory back from me. I'll not kill you, Prince. Just give me the coin. Prince, I don't want you to die. At least, you should not die without your memories.
What are you doing, Prince?
Mahatma Gandhi Memorial Post Office, Osborne Road. It's near that phone booth.
Mahatma Gandhi Post Office in Durban?
Maya, I think this could be it. We should go check it out. All the safe deposit lockers have 6 digits on them. Every locker has 6 numbers. I said in my message that Gandhiji is looking after it. I also said, take care of the letters, right?
Right.
G-A-N-D-H-I. 6 letters. Give me your phone. Quick. G-A. N-D-H-I 426-344. We are looking for 426-344. 426-344. Come, let's go. Hi.
What can I do for you, sir?
We would like a safety deposit box.
Oh, that will be 50 rands. Here, please fill up the form.
Is it possible to get 426-343?
I'll just check that for you, sir.
426-343, please.
Oh, you're in luck, sir. It's vacant.
Thank you. May I?
Sure, sir.
Maya.
Hmm?
Security cameras. Cover me.
जन्नत के सजाई मैंने तेरे लिए, छोड़ दी खुदाई मैंने तेरे लिए। जन्नत के सजाई मैंने तेरे लिए, छोड़ दी खुदाई। तेरे लिए जो मुझे माना बन के तेरे लिए, वादा है मेरा मैं हूँ तेरे लिए, होना कभी तू जुदा। दीवाना बन के तेरे लिए, वादा है मेरा मैं हूँ तेरे लिए, होना कभी तू जुदा।
Here, Prince. The coin? Please?
Prince. Sarang did a terrible thing with you. You know, if it had been with me, it would have been far worse for you.
Sherry.
Good. So now I don't have to tell Prince that you stole that coin from me. Come on, Prince. Be a good boy. And give me my coin back.
One coin. And two who want it. Maya.
Guys, get ready.
Bye.
Shan Hick.
What happened?
He doesn't have the coin.
We didn't find the coin and we also kidnapped Prince.
If he doesn't have the coin, then Maya must have it. And to save her dear Prince, Maya will give us the coin.
Yes, she will give the coin and one day she and Prince will kill us.
Will you shut up? Sherry was going to pay us 100 million for that coin.
Sherry is dead.
So what? Now Sarang will pay us.
Serena! Where are they?
They fled. Let's go. Mike? Hello, Mike?
No.
Priya,
I know you have the coin.
But before you go to Sarang, you will have to come to me for sure.
Sarang has a brain mapper. What do you have?
I have. I have got Prince.
Maya, where are you?
Officer Khan, I have found their location.
Maya, we need the coin.
You'll get it, but first I need to save Prince.
The location is?
Just a second.
Okay.
Yes, tell me.
Oshaka, Sea World, Sea Point, two of them.
Okay, Maya. We'll be there in a while. You just hold fort, okay?
Found them. Let's go.
Your gun.
First, tell me how you are going to save Prince's life.
I have a copy of the brain mapper software which I took from Sarang's laptop.
Prince's life is at stake here. How can I trust you?
You have to, Maya, you have to. Sarang wanted to kill Prince as soon as he gets the coin. I made this copy to save Prince's life. Please, Maya, believe me. Prince has very little time.
Gun. Let me see, darling. The coin that's responsible for all this, how does it look?
Priya, Prince has very little time.
Please, baby, I just want to see it. Thank you.
What are you doing, Priya? Give me back the coin.
You are so stupid, Mike. Did you think that a girl like me can fall in love with an idiot like you? No, Maya. There's just one idiot in this room. And that's not me. I will shoot if I have to. Bye, loser.
I was right. You are a loser, Mike.
Don't worry, Maya. Prince will be absolutely fine. And I'm not a loser. I have got the real coin. You know, I had learned about Priya's greed a long time back.
So which coin was that?
The same duplicate coin that you gave Prince and Prince gave it to Sarang. If I can steal the entire brain mapper software from Sarang's laptop, can't I steal a coin? Okay. This is it. Here it goes.
You're incomplete without your memory, Prince. And I'm incomplete without you. Come back, Prince. Or else we'll lose this battle. Come back, Prince. Please. Come back, Prince.
Come on.
To live, but maybe you are in a hurry to die.
Sarina.
We know you are here, but there is no escape for you this time. Do you hear me? No escape, Sarang. Put your hands up and come out one by one.
Go, go! Wait.
Prince, I'm sorry.
Sarang, Prince.
Let him go. We have got the coin. Go.
Firing from within. Looks like they're running out of bullets.
No, Sarang is escaping from the back room. Don't worry, Prince. We'll figure out Sarang's location very soon. Colonel Khanna has gone after him.
Colonel Khanna didn't go after him. He went with him.
What the heck?
Blanks. There were no bullets in any of Igrip's guns.
We were wrong the whole time. Sarang had already bribed Colonel Khanna. He had all the possible details. He knew everything, damn it. And now we have lost him.
Trust us, Officer Khan. We'll find him.
How? We just won't be able to find him now.
We will. No matter where Sarang has gone, he must have worn his shoes.
I'm sorry, but sometimes good news comes to those who wait for it.
Do you have the coin?
Yes, and very soon it will be in your hand.
Sarang.
Yes.
Where are we going? Is it safe?
I am safe. Don't know about you.
What?
Just kidding. Look outside, Khanna. This is Sharakia, the point between the border of Pakistan and Afghanistan, which is no man's land, but it belongs to everyone. There is a base camp located 7 kilometers from here. Here you can find every weapon from every country, but no weapon of any country can locate us here.
Tell Khanna that Prince can locate you anywhere.
How did you find out about my location?
Ask your shoe, Sarang.
My shoe?
It's showtime. Sarang, the coin.
Thank you.
सजाई मैंने तेरे लिए, छोड़ दी खुदाई मैंने तेरे लिए, जन्नत के सजाई मैंने तेरे लिए, छोड़ दी खुदाई। तेरे लिए जो मुझी माना बन के तेरे लिए, वादा है मेरा मैं हूँ तेरे लिए, होना कभी तू जुदा। दीवाना बन के तेरे लिए, वादा है मेरा मैं हूँ तेरे लिए, होना कभी तू जुदा।
चेहरा होगा चेहरे पे सितम तेरी बाहों में मर मिटेंगे हम अभी जा सनम यू ना कर सितम तेरी बाहों में मर मिटेंगे अभी जा सनम सितम तेरी बाहों में
अभी जा सनम यूं ना कर सितम तेरी